Well, ladies and gentlemen, now it is my honor to call upon our next speaker. Well, our next session is by someone who absolutely needs no introduction. He's been working with Asian Paints since the last 30 years in various capacities across sales, marketing, and manufacturing. He's currently working as the MD and CEO of Asian Paints, overlooking business of more than 18,900 crores in India. He has been responsible of propelling the Asian Paints brand into a league of its own and has initiated a lot of new initiatives to grow the business over the last decade. He's somebody who's closely associated with color and is also called the game changer for bringing color into the AP strategy. He's also a member of the Color Marketing Group, CMG USA, and a keen member of the AP Color Next Trends Group. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time to welcome none other than Amit Singhal, MD and CEO, Asian Paints. Well, I'd really like to welcome you with a huge round of applause. And I hope a lot of people in the audience, Mr. Singhal, could also clap along from wherever they are watching. So a lot of applause coming right there. Thank you, sir, for joining us. Over to you. How are you feeling today?
Yeah, thank you, Bhavna, for inviting me over here. And it's great to be on this platform.
Pleasure, sir. Feeling great to have you. Over to you. We'd love to hear what you have to say. Thank you.
Okay, as part of, being here and looking at TV first in terms of what is there, I wanted to just share some, thoughts which I had in terms of, how TV as a media has been really very, very strong in terms of building brands. And while we see that there is an emergence of lots of other media mixes which are kind of coming up, but I think TV still kind of reigns supreme to that extent in terms of the way it is to that extent. So I wanted to share a small presentation with you, and I'll take some quick time and not bore you in terms of some, dreary facts or something like that, but just share some stuff which our thoughts are emanating from how as a brand we have used TV in a very strong way. So I'm just sharing my screen in terms of, so hope my screen is visible, and there we go.
Thank you.
So I think the whole essence of this session is all about how building brands with TV first is the most trusted and the most effective way in terms of what we kind of do. We all are aware in terms of some of the facts and figures that today when we look at TV as a primary screen for overall Indian households, we reach out to more than 892 million viewers who are kind of residing across 210 million households. So I think that's a huge ambit in terms of what you are able to touch just by being on this media. And for example, that any brand which has got a pan-India presence and is really kind of all across the country into the hinterland as well, this is a media which really maximizes the reach and, to be very, very effective. It is something which you can use to really build brands and keep your saliency high. And obviously all this comes at a cost, which you can really see that over a period of time, this is something which can really be kind of taken on, because that's the cost which finally flattens out as you look at the whole area of the brand equity, which you have built up with this kind of media. Obviously, I think 2020, I think the year of TV, and some people say the year of digital, but I would say that very clearly, I think overall, when we see the entire unprecedented situation, I think we saw so many people just glued onto the television, and looked at various things in terms of what they were there. And therefore, I think the kind of eyeballs which we were getting were pretty strong to that extent. Overall viewership grew by, 9% as per the data which has been published. TV household ownership in rural markets also grew by 9%. And if you look at the Hindi speaking markets, that was also a growth of about 8%. And overall at the, all India level at about by 7%. Okay. IPL viewership into 2020 for the opening match was a record by itself, I think, which kind of really justifies that any impact property like that can really kind of shake the viewership in a very, very strong manner. Overall, I think as we saw 2020, a very, very difficult year. really unprecedented the way it kind of really went. We saw that TV was a very, very strong choice media across households in a very strong way. So I think these are some things which I'm sure all of you know, and this is something which is there. I wanted to just now take you through some game changers, which at Asian Paints we have used when we have looked at TV in a very, very strong way. And I wanted to give you a short and crisp case study in terms of the whole area of how we really built up a brand, which is the whole area of Har Ghar Kuch Kehta Hai. I'm sure you're all familiar with this. And, you know, way back in 2000, when we started, early 2000, when we started this, okay, we said that let's look at in terms of how we could kind of really build this across over the years and see how its progression in TV can be, which can really give us a brand which really connects. So I think what we really learned at that point of time, that emotional advertising works the best. And we really looked at connecting with the people in a very, very strong way. And what we soon learned was that, you know, it is definitely, and this is obviously an estimate, but it is definitely about 1.5 times more effective as compared to functional. And therefore, it also has a very, very strong residual value in terms of, as we see in terms of going. Like to just share, a masterpiece at that point of time, what we created, and that started the whole journey of Har Ghar Kuch Kehta Hai.
चुपचाप से ये कहता है कि अंदर इसमें कौन रहता है छत बताती है ये किसका आसमां है रंग कहते हैं किसका ये जहां है कमरों में किसकी कल्पना झलकती है इस फर्श पर नंगे पैर किसके बच्चे चलते हैं कौन चुन चुन के इसे प्यार से सजाता है कौन इस मकान में अपना घर बसाता है हर घर चुपचाप से ये कहता है कि अंदर इसमें कौन रहता है एशियन पेंट्स क्योंकि हर घर कुछ कहता है
सो इफेक्टिव वाज द एंटायर कम्युनिकेशन दैट यू नो द काइंड ऑफ फीडबैक व्हिच वी गॉट आई थिंक पीपल क्राइड पीपल रिलेटेड टू द होल इमोशनल क्वेश्चन वेरी वेरी स्ट्रांगली एंड ऑब्वियसली देयर वाज अ मास्टर क्राफ्ट्समैन पीयूष हु हैड रेंडर्ड हिज वॉइस which I think really kind of made a cut through in terms of the overall media. And that started our progression in terms of the whole journey going ahead. And then we looked at going in terms of a step further and say that, as we kind of keep on building this on the TV, what is it that we can do? And in the year 2007, we looked at in terms of seeing a different facet of this Har Ghar. So where was the first facet was more internal, we looked at Har Ghar in a very strong way where even the external connect with the home comes in very, very strongly. And this is what we did.
कैसे एक मकान चुपके से घर बन जाता है क्यों उस घर का दरवाजा हरदम खुला नजर आता है क्यों पड़ोसी अपने घर से ज्यादा इस घर में नजर आते हैं कभी दाल कभी चीनी कभी दालचीनी मांगने आ जाते हैं पोस्टमैन भी सिर्फ नाम देख के चिट्ठी ले आता है एग्जाम से पहले बच्चों के बेस्ट फ्रेंड्स पढ़ने यहीं क्यों आते हैं रोटियां यहां पर कभी गिन के क्यों नहीं बनती क्यों होली खेलने पूरा मोहल्ला यहीं पर जुटता है क्यों दिवाली का पहला पटाखा यहीं से छूटता है क्यों क्रिकेट में हारते हारते यहां इंडिया जीत जाता है कैसे एक घर सबकी जिंदगी में रंग लाता है हर घर चुपचाप से ये कहता है कि अंदर इसमें कौन रहता है एशियन पेंट्स
So the entire thing started building very, very strongly, as we saw in terms of the whole emotional connect building up. And I think the reach was really multiplied in terms of the way we use TV across. And I think this was almost language neutral in terms of how it kind of reached and started kind of really affecting the people. And we took this journey forward. and then looked at in terms of saying that another time went by when we started building with lots of things. We were flooded with stories across from households in terms of how their home has an identity of their personality in a very, very strong way. And we started kind of really seeing the stories. And this is one of the story which actually came out from one of the recipients who kind of spoke of that this is what really happened. And this is what we translated it to. So enjoy this ad.
तो ये है कैप्टन राठौर का घर, बहुत सुंदर है।
बस थोड़ा ट्राई किया,
देख के ही लगता है किसी आर्मी वाले का घर है। हर चीज अपनी जगह, परफेक्ट, बिल्कुल तुम्हारी मूंछों की तरह। और ये कुशन्स को देखो, ऐसे लग रहा है जैसे मार्च पास्ट कर रहा है। ये तो मेरे घर जैसा है।
ताकि तुम्हें ऐसा ना लगे कि तुम अपना घर छोड़ के आई हो।
कितने प्यार से अपनों के लिए कोई घर सजाता है। एशियन पेंट्स, हर घर कुछ कहता है।
So I think this really completed the whole area of Har Ghar, and I think the emotional connect was very, very strong. And you know what we saw was that it kind of really made Asian Paints as a household name. You know, the whole area of mind share was so big that we saw that almost 8 out of 10 people who were visiting any shop had first recall of Asian Paints coming in very, very strongly. And I think this was something which was very strong in terms of how the brand was built. And when we looked at, just an extension of it last year, we looked at really building it further. And, the time when the pandemic had just come in, there was a lockdown completely. Asian Paints was the first one to kind of really see that how we can really help the government and the community. And we launched the whole range of sanitizers in a very, very strong way. And we said that how do we kind of really leverage this so that we can really kind of announce that you are literally, extending the home equity through the sanitizers in a very, very strong way. And thus emerged this entire property called Ghar Ka Pehredar. And that's something which what we did very strongly in terms of looking at how we could kind of communicate that we have launched sanitizers.
ये जो घर की चार दीवारी है, यहाँ मेरी भी कुछ जिम्मेदारी है। जिम्मेदारी है यहाँ रहने वाले परिवार की, यहाँ आने वाले हर दोस्त, हर रिश्तेदार की। घर के कोने कोने पर मेरी नजर है, तभी तो यहाँ किसी को ना कोई चिंता ना कोई डर है। इस घर की खुशियों का मैं भी जिम्मेदार हूँ। हाँ, मैं इस घर का पहरेदार हूँ।
Viro Protect Sanitizers from Asian Paints.
मैं इस घर का पहरेदार हूँ।
So this was also amazing, and this just kind of sets the tone for all of you to just understand that, how emotional advertising works. And I think when you kind of use TV as a media, it just multiplies the whole effectiveness in a very, very strong way. So I think that was the game changer one, really, in terms of how we used going forward. The second game changer, which I would kind of really talk about, is the impact properties in terms of how they can be a very, very strong zone in terms of really giving you effectiveness. And I think this is something which we have kind of built into our strategy in a very strong manner, where we keep on looking at impact properties. Okay, they might come at higher CPRPs, but I think what you get is a huge amount of effectiveness, which is almost 3 times regular compared to the other GRPs in terms of what you would kind of get. So therefore, I think that becomes a very, very strong zone in terms of how it would work. So whether it is national or it is the Hindi-speaking markets, or even it is in terms of regional, I think this is something which works across in a very, very strong manner. And that is something which we have used in a big way over a period of time. The third game changer, which is very important, is that, you know, the whole area of building brands, I think it is very, very strong, because today, I think the whole diversity with respect to what you get in terms of reaching your target, you know, groups is very, very strong. So whether it is a far more younger audience, which you are looking at, or there is a certain customer classification in terms of what you want to reach out, if you look at across media, obviously, I think TV is something which gives you the max kind of effectiveness and reach in a very, very strong manner. And this is something which I think has been true over a period of time, and it still stays very strongly. Obviously, I think, you know, there is part of the mix which you kind of really evolve if you want to kind of concentrate on a certain segment or a certain younger generation in terms of what you want to do. But today, actually, I think very clearly, the diversity which you get in terms of reaching various kinds of target audiences is something which is really supreme in terms of what you keep on getting through this. So the other thing which, so how we use this whole kind of learning was that we use this in terms of building our brand. So whether it was a, you know, a premium brand, we have a waterproofing brand called Smart Care, and how we built it. So whether it was a CTA, which is a call to action kind of advert, which we kind of used, which, you know, the TV really helped us maximize the reach. It was almost like a 75% plus reach at one plus kind of a zone. We got terrific results, 1 lakh missed calls every year, 200% increase in search volumes, and a 70% plus cut through. I think it was amazing that you could kind of do something which is premium, and it gave you such results. And at the same time, we did something which was diametrically opposite in terms of a tractor brand, which is a value emulsion, which draws an unorganized customer into the organized kind of market, where also I think the results were stupendous in terms of building the brand through both urban and rural India in terms of a 80% plus reach at one plus kind of a zone. So I think what we saw in there also was that, you know, in terms of total awareness, the second most recalled AP brand, you know, again, a 75% plus creative recall, and really it established the imagery of being something which is affordable and durable to that extent, which really served the purpose in terms of the preposition which we wanted to really take to the customer. So I think this is something which we are finding that today you can use it for any kind of customer segmentation far more strongly. And it has got this really universality, which kind of comes in with the kind of diversity it kind of offers overall. The game changer 4 is about rural as being very, very critical. And I think we all saw in 2020 that how T3, T4 cities were doing far better. And really, you know, what we call as the urban, I think, was something which was the call of the day, where we saw that there were a lot of customers who were still buying into thing because, you know, it was largely unaffected as compared to the metros and T1 cities. And TV really helped us to deliver in rural markets. So whether it was FTAs, GECs, movies, news and support, you know, all critical genres, we use regional channel boosters and cable channels also to kind of maximize the whole reach across. And we found that, you know, by doing all this, there was a very, very strong brand disposition and a higher reach across rural markets, which came in a very, very strong manner. And it really kind of gave us that kind of a penetration which was required at that point of time. And I can really say that, you know, the rural markets, as we say, were growing at almost 3 times the rate as compared to the metros and T1s. And this really gave the fillip in terms of making this possible as we went by. The game changer 5 is about being always on. Okay. And one could question in terms of how would you kind of really see in terms of monies spread like this. But this is something which we have experienced, that is something which has been giving very, very strong results. So you need to maximize weeks on air, you know, and it kind of gives you a very, very strong brand saliency. And that is something which we have used. And it's almost like that you kind of launch something, and to maintain saliency, you have got at least 50 weeks on air. And this really is what bringing the top of mind awareness and brings the whole credibility and trust for key categories. And, you know, we just heard Sam saying also this, that in any key brand building effort, it is not like an on-off switch. that you just put in something on the air, then you kind of are absent for 2-3 weeks, then you again come back, do a something there and kind of go off. It can't be like that. So I think what we've learned the lesson very well is that today, I think sometimes situations will come, but that should not deter you, because I think it pays long dividends for being salient over a period of time, and it can't be used as an on-off switch in terms of going just like this. So I think that is something which is a big learning which we have taken over a period of time, which always helped us in terms of building the brand on the TV. The game changer 6, which has been very strong, is to partner with TV channels and create content. And, really this integration connects better with the viewers, because, people are glued to their favorite impact properties. And if you are able to integrate the brand there and, look at content which makes sense, I think that is something which really works. So I wanted to just show you some examples in terms of the work which we did here. This is an exterior brand in terms of what we tied up with India News and
CNN. Rumination Bala Ultima Protect aapke ghar ko deta hai protection dhoop, barish aur dhool se bilkul usi tarah jaise jhoot aur afwahon se aapko bachata hai aur khabron ki sachchai ko protect karta hai. Aapka favorite show aaj ki baat Rajat Sharma ke saath sombar se shukrawar raat 9 baje. Presented by Asian Paints Lamination Wala Ultima Protect, Barish Dhoop Dhool Ko Aane Do.
So that was one example. The second example, obviously tied up.
बहुत बहुत बधाई आपको एक बार फिर तनाशी आपसे मिलकर बात करके आज गांधी जयंती के अवसर पर हमें बहुत अच्छा लगा और जाने से पहले एक आपको एक सूचना मैं देना चाह रहा हूँ दिव्य सजनों इस हफ्ते जितने भी खिलाड़ी हॉट सीट पर आए हैं उन्होंने अपने जीवन में उपलब्धि का एक और रंग भर दिया है अब बारी है उनके घर को रंगों से भरने की और ये जिम्मेदारी उठाई है एशियन पेंट्स ने अपने रॉयल हेल्थ शील्ड एंटी बैक्टीरियल पेंट से इन सभी खिलाड़ियों के घरों को प्रोटेक्शन के साथ नए रंगों का उपहार देने का फैसला किया है तो बहुत बहुत बधाई आपके घर को जो है एशियन पेंट्स की ओर से एक उपहार आपको दिया जा रहा है बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद
So I think this is an example in terms of what you've been kind of doing and don't want to show you every impact work which we did in terms of creating content. But this is a very, very strong example in terms of how you really built up your brand and really use content to integrate with impact properties in a strong way. And I think this really kind of really energizes the whole brand building in a very strong manner as we kind of go ahead. When we look at the Game Changer 7, I think a very strong piece of advice to everyone. I think we need to very, very strongly concentrate on creatives, and creatives really play a very, very important role. So whether it is a creative which is for the Northwest market or it is for any of the regional markets, what we felt is that even for regional markets, the dubbing really doesn't help in terms of a creative. I think if you keep it local and you keep it simple, I think it really kind of really helps you in terms of in a very strong manner. And obviously, I think, the average duration, I think, is a very, very important part in terms of, getting a certain frequency in terms of what you can really air the ad in a big way. So I think just quick examples in terms of how local and how regional you can get and how the cut through really works very strongly.
Sir, paint to Pramod Marke. அது பெயிண்ட் இல்லப்பா லேமினேஷன் ஒரு வாட்டி அடிச்சா 10 வருஷத்துக்கு லேமினேஷன்
ஏஷியன் பெயிண்ட்ஸ் அல்டிமா ப்ரொடெக்ட் வீட்டுக்கே லேமினேஷன்
another one there
ஏண்டி கண்ணல் சார் என்ன மண்டி போதுண்டா லேமினேஷன் இந்திக்கு மட்டுமே நீக்காது Asian Paints Ultima Protect Indica Lamination.
So I think this is something which is very strong, and I think a lot of us who kind of keep on building brands in the regional market should keep in this mind that the whole area of keeping it local really works, and if you make it simple, I think that's something which really gets you a very good impact and a mind measure. The last game changer which I want to speak is the one where we use, how we kind of really looked at connecting with the youth very, very strongly. And today, youth is becoming a very, very strong part of our target audience. And how we looked at when we moved away from our brand ambassador, who was Saif, and moved to a much youthful positioning through Born to Decorate kind of a zone, where this is the time when we really kind of made the possibility of decorating your homes with textures, which were, far more vibrant, far more playful. And therefore, we said that how do we kind of really start reaching to the younger audiences far more stronger? And this is how we kind of really use the media in terms of TV, in terms of very strongly to kind of build this, enjoy this advert. So I think, massive spike we got in terms of people just querying in terms of what is Royal Play. And, you know, we became almost most searched brand amongst the target audience at that point of time. And I think this game changer really worked very, very strongly in terms of what we were able to achieve. So I think in summary, I think the most important part I would say is that, these are some of some basic simple areas which we have learned over a period of time, that using TV, which is so effective and so trusted, that we are able to kind of really multiply the impact, look at really causing and building your brands in a very, very strong way. And it is something which is, such a strong medium that we feel that it will always be there. Obviously, I think now today when we look at is that it's not that you don't kind of mix and really use a multitude of media. So it could be, like the digital, which is coming up in a big way, and you use sometimes print in terms of looking at generating more CTAs if you have a CTA-led kind of advert, which kind of really happens. But at the same time, I think today TV kind of still reigns supreme, as I said earlier, and it is finally the most effective and the most trusted to that extent. So I think that's it. I wanted to share this stuff with you. And I think this is something which has been a bit of a learning from our side. And I thought it would be good to kind of share it with you in this forum.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Mr. Singhal Farsi, for joining us, and definitely for being our jury chair. It really means a lot to us. Thank you for that. Mr. Singhal, I have a couple of questions coming in from the audience. Would it be okay if I can take it with you live?
Sure.
Thank you. Well, Mr. Singhal, you mentioned that rural grew at a faster rate than urban. Which markets do you see driving growth in 2021?
So what I see is that obviously, again, the way we have started, it has been very, very unexpected, unfortunately. And I see is when I see even quarter one this year, I see very clearly that the rural markets would kind of really be very, very strong. One, we have the harvest, which has come in for a good agricultural output, which has happened. And secondly, what we see is that even in today's regime, the rural markets are lesser affected and so on and so forth. So I think the demand areas are very, very strong. But I think as we kind of really see this phase turn over, I would say that possibly there is a bit of a pent-up demand, which is there in metros and T1, T2 cities as well. I think the urban markets would also strongly come back as we near more the festivities of quarter two and so on and so forth to that extent. So I would principally say that the first half could be dominated by the rural markets, but second half, we would kind of say a very strong participation from the urban markets coming in very strongly.
Sure. Mr. Singhal, as a marketer, should we continue advertising in tough times to build brand awareness, or be in top, you know, and be top of mind, or should we look at conserving cash now? Your views on that?
Okay, I am very, very clear and very strong on this, and I concur with Sam in a very big way in terms of what he said earlier. I strongly feel that marketing and advertising is not like an on and off switch. You know, you can't really just switch it off when you feel that the environment is really kind of working against you, and see that, you know, we could kind of come back when the environment is conducive. Because what I feel is that the brand building is more medium to long term to that extent. And if you kind of really take off your monies at a certain point of time, you will impact your brand, because in today's world, the way competition is there, if you use your lose your positioning, and if you lose your connect with your loyal consumers, you will find it very difficult, and you might spend three times the money to really get back those consumers in a very strong way. So I'm a big proponent of the fact that you should not kind of really withdraw for your marketing mix to that extent, and keep on kind of nurturing your loyal consumers, even if the situation is not looking great.
Sure. Mr. Singhal, towards the end, what's, you know, with such a rich experience you have, what's that advice to the advertisers currently? Your few takes on that whilst we conclude your session.
So I would say that I think the golden rules are that, we need to kind of really keep our, marketing mix simple, use very, very strong, creatives, which possibly really touch the consumer in a very strong way. Go emotional wherever you could kind of really go in terms of touching people, because that is something where the residual value of the brand really kind of builds up in a very, very strong manner. And I would just say that be wise and be very, very creative in terms of how you use your monies, because today in terms of reaching out the audience is not very simple. You need to be creative, and you need to be really applying a good thought in terms of how you want to maximize reach to your target audience.
Right. Thank you so much, Mr. Singhal. Every word you spoke creates a huge wave, because a lot of people would be looking forth for your guidance right now. Thank you once again for joining us.
Thank you so much, Bhavna, for inviting me here. Thank you so much.
Pleasure, sir. Thank you.